The voltage provided by the power grid is not suitable for all electronic devices. Each device has different requirements for its power supply, such as AC or DC voltage, or it even needs different voltage levels for operation. At this point, power supplies, such as linear voltage regulators or switched mode power supplies, come into play. As the requirements for a power supply differ significantly, there exist different specifications to characterize power supplies. In this video, we will give you an overview of the most important characteristics of power supplies. Power supplies convert a given input voltage into a desired output voltage. The input and output voltages may be AC or DC voltages. Power supplies are therefore also called converters. In general, there are four main types of converters. AC-AC converters, which convert an AC voltage with a frequency and voltage level into another AC voltage with a desired frequency and voltage level. DC-AC converters, which create an AC voltage with a defined frequency and voltage level out of a DC voltage and are therefore also often referred to as voltage inverters. AC-DC converters, which do the opposite of a DC-AC converter, and DC-DC converters, which change the voltage levels of a DC voltage. In this video, we would like to deal with the different types of power supplies with DC output, as in electronics, mostly DC supply voltages are needed. These supplies can be split into three main groups: voltage stabilization circuits, linear voltage regulators, and switched mode power supplies. All of them have subtypes as well with their individual advantages and disadvantages. You can learn more about the different types of power supplies in some of our other videos. In general, all specifications can be found in the corresponding datasheets. We will now consider the most important ones. Let's start with the efficiency. The efficiency describes how much of the power of the input of the power supply remains at the output. So eta is Pout related to Pin. The efficiency is expressed in percentages. The higher the efficiency, the better, as low efficiency describes losses which are dissipated as heat. As every power supply has an input and output, there exist specifications regarding the input and output. The input specifications tell us in which voltage and frequency range the input voltage must be. The output specifications tell us the range of the output voltage if it is adjustable. As the output is a DC voltage, the frequency is naturally zero. Next, we want to explain the line regulation. This is a measure how stable the output voltage is when the input voltage changes. Ideally, the output voltage should always remain the same even if the input voltage changes. As the line regulation is described by delta V out to delta V in times 100%, low values are desirable. There is also a quantity which describes the behavior of the power supply when the load at the output changes. This quantity is called load regulation. Ideally, the output voltage should be constant no matter if there is a load change or not. This is the formula of the load regulation. VNL describes the voltage where no load is attached, and VFL describes the voltage where full load is attached, thus the load current is at the maximum that is allowed by datasheet specification. For the load regulation, low values are desirable as well. Another important quantity is the power supply rejection ratio, short PSRR, or sometimes called ripple rejection. It describes the ability of the power supply to reject ripples from the input. The PSRR is 20 times the logarithm of delta V in to delta V out. The unit is decibel. Delta V in is the ripple on the input voltage and delta V out the resulting ripple on the output. be aware that the suppression is not constant. It has a different value depending on the ripple frequency and is described in a frequency response like this one. On the x-axis, the frequency of the ripple in Hertz, and on the y-axis, the power supply rejection ratio in decibel is plotted. For the power supply rejection ratio, a high value is desired. The last specification we want to explain to you in this video is the dropout voltage of linear voltage regulators. As everything in nature, power supplies are not ideal. Losses occur in all of them, and the efficiency is never 100%. Due to these losses, which can, for example, occur at the pass device, the output voltage can never be exactly the input voltage. To achieve a certain and stable output voltage at, for example, positive linear voltage regulators, the input voltage always has to be higher than the sum of the desired output voltage and the minimum dropout voltage to guarantee the proper regulation of the linear voltage regulator. Conventional linear voltage regulators feature a minimum dropout voltage of approximately 2 volt. But there are also devices available called low dropout regulators, or LDOs, which can feature dropout voltages as low as some tens of millivolts. In summary, in this video we explained the most important specifications of power supplies to you. We talked about the efficiency, input and output specifications, line regulation, load regulation, power supply rejection ratio, and the dropout voltage. You can learn more about power supplies in one of our other videos. I'm Sabrina with the Institute of Electronics. I hope you have learned something today, but anyways, thanks for watching.